Nuclear safety. U.S. near misses in 2010. This report was generated on March 17th, 2011. There's a very important report out today by the Union of Concerned Scientists on the performance of the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, the government agency that enforces safety regulations for U.S. nuclear reactors in the hope of preventing a catastrophe such as what is occurring in Fukushima. In 2010, there were 14 near misses. And then down below, it tells where they were. So I'm going to go through these real quick. The first one was in Arkansas, Nuclear 1. No details publicly available because it was a security-related incident, and the NRC withholds such information in the wake of 9/11. Number 2, Braidwood, Joliet, Illinois. Problems included floods in buildings with safety equipment, a poor design that allowed steam to rip metal siding off containment walls, and undersized electrical fuses for vital safety equipment. Number 3, Brunswick, Southport, North Carolina. Incident equipment failure led the plant owner to declare an emergency. However, workers did not know how to operate the computer systems that notified off-site workers to report to emergency response facilities. Staffing of these facilities took longer than required. 4. Calvert Cliffs, Annapolis, Maryland. A roof known to leak for years but ignored by the plant operator shorts out electrical equipment, a reactor automatically shuts down. A worn-out protective device that workers had not replaced allows the electrical problem to trigger an automatic shutdown of a second reactor. Number 5. Catawba, Rock Hill, South Carolina. No details publicly available. Another security-related incident. Number 6, Crystal River 3, Florida, I guess that is. Workers inadvertently damaged thick concrete reactor containment walls when cutting a hole to replace steam generators. Number 7, David Bessie, Toledo, Ohio. Workers discovered through wall cracks in nozzles of control rod drive mechanisms. These cracks leak after workers failed to account for peak temperatures inside the reactor vessel. Number 8, Diablo Canyon, San Luis Obispo, California. A misguided repair to valves that would not open fast enough prevent other key valves from working. The reactor operated for nearly 18 months with vital systems disabled. Number 9, Farley, Sotham, Alabama. A replacement pump with a manufacturing defect fails after workers did not ensure that it met key parameters specified in the purchase order. Number 10, Fort Calhoun, Omaha, Nebraska. Pumps in an emergency water system fail repeatedly over several years. Number 11, H.B. Robinson, Florence, South Carolina. An electrical cable shorts out and starts a fire. Electrical problems disrupt the supply of cooling water to the pump seals for the reactor coolant system. Cooling water leaks into the containment building. Control room operators do not notice the lack of cooling for more than 30 minutes. The reactor shuts down, and the operator starts two pumps that transfer water from a tank in an auxiliary building. When the tank empties, the pumps are supposed to automatically realign to take water from another storage tank. The realignment fails to happen, and operators do not notice the failure for nearly an hour. 4 hours into the event, the operators attempt to restore power, but do not check first to ensure that workers had fixed the original fault. When the operators close the electrical breaker to a circuit, they cause another short out and another fire. Number 12, H.B. Robinson, Florence, South Carolina. One of the four pumps supplying cooling water to the reactor vessel experiences motor failure and automatically shuts down. A series of operator errors trying to compensate for the problem ensues. Number 13, Surrey, Newport News, Virginia. Incident after an inadvertent shutdown of a reactor. A fire starts in the control room due to an overheated electrical component. A similar component in another unit's control room had started a fire 6 months earlier, but the operator failed to fix the problem in other control rooms. Number 14, Wolf Creek, Burlington, Kansas. 7 hours after the reactor shut down automatically because of a problem with the electrical grid, an NRC inspector found water leaking from the system that cools the emergency diesel generators and virtually all other emergency equipment. An internal study in 2007 had forecast such leakage, and a leak had actually occurred after a reactor shutdown in April of 2008. However, the owner had taken few steps to correct this serious safety problem. Oh boy. I find this to be extremely disturbing. Extremely disturbing. The lack of training, the lack of the NRC to put these at a red level. They do have different levels of oversight when they have a condition. The first one is called a special inspection team, or SIT. When the risk rises by 100, the agency dispatches an augmented inspection team, AIT. And when the risk increases by 1,000 or more, they send out incident inspection team, IIT. The 14 near misses report all the events that spurred the NRC to send out an SIT or an AIT. I don't know about you, but I think all 14 of these issues sound to me like they were doggone serious. So it just goes to show you, here we are, you know, running nuclear power plants and without emergency implementations, people just being lackadaisical, not, you know, this is not acceptable. This is absolutely not acceptable. Oh boy, alrighty. I just wanted to get this out here. It's just more of the same old stuff going on in the United States. You know, like we're paying to have these things built. We're paying to have them monitored. And we're going to pay with our lives and our children's lives when they all go. Oof, God bless.